What's up, y'all? It's your girl, Stephanie. Today, I'm gonna show you how I pack for cold weather trips. I absolutely love traveling to cold places. Maybe it's because I've lived in California my whole life, but I really prefer traveling to colder climates than warmer ones. Last November, I went to Iceland, which was so beautiful and otherworldly, and I just got home from Yellowstone with my family. So yeah, as I was packing, I realized I have a couple tips and tricks up my sleeve when it comes to packing for these places. You know, you have to be very conservative with what you bring, because obviously you're bringing clothing that is much bulkier, but you also don't want to bring your largest luggage, because a lot of times you're going to be packing it into like rental cars or kind of going over rough terrain. So you don't really want to bring a lot of stuff, but you still want to look cute and look different in different photos on different days. So I kind of wrote it out, broke it down into different categories, and I'm gonna share it with you today. If you wanna see more videos like these, please make sure to subscribe below. Come join the sisterhood, no matter your true pronoun or gender identity. Come join the family. Let's get started. In terms of luggage, I would really recommend a hard case luggage. You never know if it's gonna get wet. I do really like those cushy luggages where you can really stuff stuff into there, but obviously there's no protection there from water. And if they're moving things onto a plane and it's raining, like your stuff could get soaked. Really would recommend a hard case. I've been using my Calipak one for maybe like a couple of years now. I really love Calipak luggage. I would highly recommend it. Super smooth wheels. All the finishings are really great. For a trip like this, I would recommend going with the like middle size, because they have a carry-on size, a middle size, and then they have like a pretty large size. The middle one you can't carry on. You have to check it in. I think the middle size is great for a two-week trip. You can really pack a good amount of clothing in there. In terms of what I bring with me on a plane, I would recommend a backpack like this. This is my Adidas backpack that I've been using for many years now, and I really love this backpack because it has this kind of like shell thing going on. So you can really fit a good amount of stuff in here, and it's quite slender, and it just sits really nicely on my back. It has a little sleeve for my computer, and you know, I bring a lot of electronics with me, so this thing is pretty much just stuffed with chargers, my camera stuff. I obviously wanna keep that on my body and not put it into a luggage. I also really like the computer pocket, because a lot of times I'll put my like documents or like cash or something behind the computer, so it's right up against my back. Yeah, so I really, really do like this backpack. And then also, if you wanna bring something extra in case you think you might be getting, you know, some gifts or buying clothing or something while you're there, I would always recommend packing a duffel bag with you, so having it flat. There's a bunch of stuff in here right now, but let's just show you the size of this. I also have a larger version of this Le Sport sack, so this is the smaller version, and when you kind of fold it up, this thing folds up to super, super small. So yeah, if you think that you're gonna buy some stuff, like you might as well bring a duffel with you just in case you wanna check one more thing. So yeah, those are just like the luggage things and like carry-on stuff. And now we're gonna get into the clothing. So I'm gonna start off with probably the most outermost layers into the innermost. So I think obviously if you're going to a cold place, the biggest thing you need is like a nice puffy jacket. And also, when I talk about cold weather, like I'm not talking about Arctic climates. Like I've been to Alaska in the winter time, Iceland in November, and these things really worked for me. So I'm not speaking on behalf of like everybody. You might need more or you might need less, but this just worked for me, you know? So here I have this jacket from Diamond Supply, and actually has like this false hoodie thing, but it is a really good puffy jacket, and I really do like how the zipper, it zips all the way up so it can cover your face if need be. And the hood is just a really nice thick hood. It's like double lined, and it really does cover closely into the face really well. I also really like this jacket in particular because it has really good outside pockets, but also they have inner pockets too. So there's two pockets on the inside of this jacket that I can just toss stuff into. A lot of times I'll be carrying my vlogging camera and a GoPro and my phone and my wallet. Like I'll put it all in here and it actually fits in this jacket. So something like this is super key. I'll talk about like upper stuff. So in terms of like layering with sweaters, I would always say bring one nice plain sweater. This is a cashmere sweater that is so warm. Like cashmere is incredible. It's just the softest and the warmest thing. And I got this one from Nordstrom Rack. Something like this, and I'll talk about looking nicer for like dinners and stuff, but this is good for going out at night, I feel like, to a nice dinner, or for wearing in the daytime as a layering thing. And then also I have this sweatshirt right here from Topshop, which is just a really nice, soft, easy sweatshirt to throw on. Since I live in LA, I don't own a lot of super thick, crazy sweaters or crazy thick clothing. So for me, clothing is all about layering upon layering. So if you were to wear this, I would wear like a t-shirt like this underneath, wear this, and then I would wear something like this flannel right here, and then even potentially the jacket. Not even potentially, I would wear the puffy jacket on top. So this is a thick flannel. And if you just go thrifting, you can find these everywhere. You can find them in the men's section or the women's. I would recommend going to the men's section to try and find one of these thicker flannels. There's like Pendleton ones, but you don't have to get like a crazy brand. A flannel like this will keep you so warm. You button it all the way up to the top and your core is warm. Your other option too for a flannel is something like this. So this is like maybe for if you want to layer, but you're not going to like such a crazy cold place like Iceland. This is something that I might just bring along if I feel like I have enough layers, but maybe it might get colder, so I'll just wear this around my waist. And also, this kind of thing is great for taking photos, because if you are wearing the same kind of outfit all the time, for photos, what you can do is like throw this flannel on top, or you take it off, take your sweatshirt off, have this t-shirt, have this flannel around your waist. That's why layering is really great for traveling and for photos, is because if you want a different photo, but you're wearing kind of the same clothing, just take one piece off or put one piece on, style it differently for the photo really fast, and then, you know, you can put everything back on again. So these are the kind of things I would bring for my tops. And also, I would bring like a good amount of like t-shirts like this. So underneath everything, I wear a different t-shirt. You can wear like different like plain t-shirt, or the long tees are really great. I also bring those ones. But just having some sort of thing that's like really close to your body will really help keep you warm, and also really nice for when you're going like in and out of buildings and stuff, and it's just like really warm in a building, you seem to tear everything off. Sometimes you don't even want a sweater on, you know? So it's nice to have a t-shirt underneath. In terms of the pants, I would really recommend getting some sort of jean like this. This is from A. Goldie. This is actually my favorite jean company right now. I just really love how their jeans fit, and it's just really quality, thick denim. This one is not a stretchy denim at all, and it's more of like a looser boot cut fit. And the reason why I like these kind of jeans for traveling to cold places is because you wanna sometimes wear something underneath. So something like these two things right here. So right here I have straight up just like, I don't know, pantyhose? What do you call it, pantyhose? But they're like the thick wool kind. So they go all the way onto your feet. You don't even have to wear socks, or you can wear socks on top if you're wearing something like this. Yeah, this one kind of has like lint all over it because I've worn it with different things like different sweatpants and stuff. I wore this one a bunch in Iceland, actually, because that's where I really needed to layer up. So that's why it's good to have like looser jeans like these to wear these underneath. And I also will bring a pair of my like classic skinny jeans from like Topshop. I just always like to have a pair of those on me. And those do go over these. You just have to work with it. Like, you have to kind of like inch it up so it doesn't bunch up like all around your waist, you know? But you can totally layer with skinny jeans, like no lie. It's gonna be tight, but you can definitely do it. So yeah, I would really highly recommend bringing something like this. Or if you don't have something like this, like everyone has, you know, just regular leggings, like black leggings. Like, just this will help your body keep really warm. It's just really important to have some sort of layer that's like very close to your body. And like I said, with these ones, like, you don't even really need to wear socks if you don't want to, but it is a good idea to maybe put another layer of socks, which would be a pair like this, perhaps. Like, I have a couple pairs actually in the wash right now that I was gonna show you, but it's okay. Like, something like this, which is like a thin wool sock, is really good. I would highly recommend, if you really are committing to this, going to go buy some merino wool socks. Merino wool is just really good wool that's not itchy, it's really soft. and it can be very thin but very, very warm. And you can get those online or at any of those like outdoorsy stores for sure. They'll have merino wool socks, and that's also good for gloves, beanies, all that stuff. Keeping other parts of your body warm is very important, especially your head and your neck. I would highly recommend bringing a couple different beanies. Here I have this one from my friend Oxcord. It's this really awesome orange beanie. I have a kind of thinner one. This one's from a brand called Crooked. This one's thinner and easy to throw around. And then this one's from Diamond Supply, and it's a thicker material. It's kind of very similar material to this one right here. Beanies are so important, or at least one of those like headbands or ear warmers. Keeping your ears warm is so, so important when you're in cold weather. And then for scarves, like around your neck, which is so important to keep this area warm, I have this circle scarf that I got as a gift many years ago. I think it's actually handmade. And I like circle scarves because you can kind of wrap it as many, I can even do it one more time if I really wanted to, but it's a kind of scarf that won't unravel, you don't lose it. I really do like circle scarves for traveling in general, because I just think it's just less annoying than other scarves. So definitely recommend one of these. And also, of course, gloves. I can't find any of my gloves right now, but you know what gloves look like. Especially for me, I wear fingerless gloves. So you can go to the drugstore, buy a pair of gloves and just chop off the fingers, or chop off like a couple of the fingers, like these ones. When I'm filming, like, I need my fingers to work. But in Iceland, I tried, I think, one day to go without gloves, like I forgot it, and I could barely like press the button. It was so cold, I was shaking so much because my hands are so cold, like I couldn't even press the record button down. So it's very important to keep your hands warm. I did wanna mention one thing. So in Iceland, we had a couple nice dinners that we had scheduled beforehand. So obviously, I wanted to look really nice, and I didn't wanna look all grubby to go into this dinner. So in my luggage, I made sure to have room for a nice coat. So this one is from Sandro. It's this beautiful thick camel coat, and it's just like my nicest coat that I own, but it's also super warm because it's so thick. It's like double lined. It has this crazy hood that is really, really warm. Yeah, I really love this kind of coat, but obviously you're gonna need some room in your luggage for something like this. The outfit that you can wear with this is like a nice sweater that would also be good to wear in the daytime as well. So something soft and nice looking. I wore my black skinny jeans and my Doc Martens. I think that's a nice outfit to me, to be honest. Like, cause I wear a lot of Doc Martens. We'll talk about that in a second. But to me, that was a nice going out outfit. So yeah, obviously if you have something that you wanna go to that's nicer, try and bring a piece that would be good for that and also good for just like regular daytime stuff. All right, so let's talk about shoes. I'm a huge Dr. Martin wearer. Here are the shoes that I wear just pretty much all day, every day. They are actually platform Doc, which are very intense and very, very heavy. We also have these classic ones. These are just like the regular classic Dr. Martin boots. These ones do not have that crazy platform, but they don't have a zipper. I used to be a boot purist. If there was a zipper on a boot, I was like, I am not gonna wear those. Like, I need to earn my stripes and have to like take minutes out of my day to tie it up. But then I got these. I think these are called the Jadens. And oh man, this zipper really does make a world of difference. But I still love these ones a lot. I would just really recommend, if you can, buying something like this, buying a pair of real Dr. Martens and breaking them in before your trip. It does take a couple weeks. It does take a little bit of time, a little bit of pain, but once you do, these things mold to your feet. They love you, and you will never slip or fall or anything. Like, I don't know what these soles are made out of. I'll show you. These are the Dr. Martens that I've owned these for many years. There is wear, but nothing like any other shoe that I've ever had. And you will not slip, you will not fall. Yeah, that's for me, what I would recommend. Also, if you have room in your luggage for a cute pair of boots, like heeled booties or something, 100% do that. And that's great also for going out at night for a nice restaurant. Totally, but I'm a Dr. Martens girl, so that's what I would bring. I would also recommend bringing just a nice pair of slippers to wear around. I don't know if you're gonna be, you know, in a cabin or where you're gonna be, but I always just bring a pair of slippers with me whenever I travel, so I'm not walking barefoot or with my socks like on like questionable grounds. Also, if you have enough room in there instead of maybe like nice boots, bringing Uggs too, because that's just kind of nice. Uggs are nice to, or some sort of version of Uggs, you know, not necessarily Uggs, to just slip on the feet and kind of go around if you're just doing something casual, because obviously these are pretty heavy and you're kind of lugging them around. So right now I kind of want to touch upon my airport outfit. So this is what I would wear to LAX, going to wherever I'm going. I kind of like pull my stuff out of this huge clothing pile I've created. 100% wear your huge coat, because you don't want to pack this, especially if you're packing another nice coat. I just bring this with me to the airport, and then I will also wear like just a t-shirt, and then also bring a flannel. So layer these on top of each other, and then I would wear the thicker jeans or the bigger jeans that you have, but without the layer underneath. And then of course I would wear the largest pair of shoes, which are these Jadens, which also are very convenient for going through security because they have a zipper, so it's super fast for me. I would just recommend maybe just wearing a couple of your bigger pieces, because this flannel does take up a good amount of room in the luggage because it is a thicker flannel. Even if you want to go as far as wearing a sweatshirt too, but if I can do without the sweatshirt, I would, because that's a lot of layers to wear, you know, at least from LA to someplace else. And once you get to that other place, if it's so freezing, like at the airport, you can throw on another layer. I created a category called accessories, but I just realized I completely grouped in the beanie, the scarf, the gloves, with all the other clothing, but I do have a couple other accessories to talk about, or I don't know if the last one's an accessory, but we have some sunglasses here. So first of all, I have my prescription sunglasses. So a lot of times if I'm traveling, I don't wear my contacts necessarily, I'll just wear my glasses, but if it gets super sunny, it's nice to have your prescription glasses on. So these are just from Warby Parker. Whoa, I should not be wearing these while I have contacts on. These are some nice sunglasses though. I just like to have a prescription pair. Maybe it's excessive to have three pairs of sunglasses, but I like to accessorize. This is another pair that I got from Urban Outfitters. I like wearing these kind of just tinted glasses in cold weather places, because a lot of the time, like, cold weather places can be pretty bright. Even if it's overcast, it's reflecting on like snow and it's just really bright. So if I'm filming, sometimes I like to have some sort of tinted glasses to wear while I'm looking at my camera. So these are from Urban Outfitters, and I will link everything down below that is available still for sure. So I'll see if these are still available. And then these ones right here, I love these. These are from my friend Adam's new company called Wet Eyewear. These are just cool and badass, and I really like the tint on these. They really block out any crazy sun reflection, but still give me visibility. Cause that's the other thing. When I'm traveling and I'm in a beautiful place, sometimes I feel like super dark sunglasses make me not be able to like experience my surroundings. So just a little bit of tint is good for me. And then the last, like, it's not an accessory at all. The last thing I wanna talk about in this category, I guess, are those little hand warmer packets. I didn't use them at all in Yellowstone, but when we went to Iceland in November, those really saved me. My mom, I think she brought from home like a few of them, and we just placed a couple in our pockets, especially because I was filming and taking photos. Like, I didn't have like a glove on at all times, and being able to stick my hands inside those pockets with the hand warmers, just game changer. We also put them into our shoes as well. So if you're going to a really, really cool place, you might wanna think about bringing some of those little hand warmer things. In terms of toiletries, it's really nothing to talk about. I would bring just my regular travel toiletries and my makeup, but I would highly recommend bringing something like the Bite Beauty Agave Mask, something that is a super thick lip product that you can coat on your lips. I'm actually wearing it right now, that is long lasting and highly moisturizing. I love the Bite Beauty one. I also really just like Vaseline, that's my other go-to, but for sure for cold weather, like, I really like this lip mask because I can slap it on, it'll stay on for a long time, and my lips get really moisturized. And it actually not only gets moisturized, but it like protects the lips, it like blocks it from the cold. So I would recommend that. And also, of course, just a thick hand moisturizer. hand cream. I've just been using like samples that I got, so I don't have one to like really talk about here. But yeah, just some sort of really nice thick hand cream, because you're gonna want to bring that with you around, because the cold really does cut through the knuckles. I think in Iceland my knuckles started bleeding a little bit because it was so dry and so cold. So yeah, those are the two things I would really recommend remembering to bring for your toiletries. Oh, you know what? This is another thing that I would recommend packing with your toiletries. Some sort of like, you can buy those individual like wool light packets for hand washing, or even just, you know, use the body wash that's at the place that you're staying. Because if you're traveling for 2 weeks and you're like, you're wearing like something like this every day, I'm not gonna pack like 14 of these, you know? So you wear it for a couple days and then you hand wash it if you're staying at a place for a couple days, and you let it just dry wherever you're staying. Also, same thing for underwear and socks. Like, I'm not gonna bring 2 weeks worth of underwear or socks. Like, I'll just hand wash in the shower a lot of times. So maybe you don't even need to bring wool light, but just be aware that it's completely a possibility for you to just wash your underwear with your body wash or something in the shower with you. But yeah, for something like this, if you wanna bring some wool light, go for it. All right, I think that's it. I know this video is going to be very, very long because I talked about a lot of different stuff, but I wanted to be thorough and let you know like why I would recommend bringing these certain things. So yeah, I really hope you found this video helpful. If you did, please make sure to subscribe below. Come join the sisterhood. I love y'all, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.